Have a few extra cards lying around? Looking to turn your rotating staples into a Theros booster box? Check out Channel Fireball's online buy list. We offer the most competitive prices on all of your unwanted cards, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a hefty 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's fast, it's easy, and as LSV would say, it's good value.
Hi everyone, this is Paulo with another Theros draft video. This pack I think is pretty straightforward. Lightning Strike is the best card here. I think it's the best common. It's better than most uncommons, actually. And there's nothing that really comes close to it, so I'm just going to take that. Red is not a good color. I think it's the worst color. The Lightning Strike is really splashable. And again, it is by far the best card in that pack, so I think just not taking it is just a mistake. Okay, this pack's interesting. There are two choices, I think. There's Chain to the Rocks and Void is End. Chain to the Rocks is the more powerful card, but it is two colors, whereas Void is End is just one color. So the question is, how much more powerful is Chain to the Rocks than Void is End that would risk taking a double color card? I do have Red already, but that doesn't really say much. So I think Chain of the Rocks is a lot more powerful than Void is End. It's basically Soup of the Hammock for one instead of for six. So I don't really know what to take here. I don't know. I think taking Void is End is better. Like, the other card is like a 9. If I manage to play it, and Void Zen is like a 7, but there's a way bigger chance that I will actually play it. So here, I think the two options are the Daxus and the Nimbus Naiad. Daxus is very, very good, but again, it is two colors. So we run into the same problem that we did before. I'm inclined to just take Nimbus Naiad here. Which, yeah, I think I'm just going to take that. I think keeping yourself open at this point is probably worth more than committing to double color. So if I had taken the Chain to Rocks, I would probably have taken the Daxus, the previous blast pack, and just committed to like a 3-color deck. And here I'm going to take Riptide. I think it's the best card in the pack. So yeah, this is a really interesting choice, I think, because in both scenarios, I think the gold card is actually better, but it's hard to justify taking a double color card this early, I don't know. So here again, we have another gold card that is better than the rest of the pack. So I think Shipwreck Singer is the best card in this pack. But I'm probably just going to take the Air Elemental here, because it's just blue. So right now I'm pretty locked into blue, but I could play blue with any color. Could even play blue-green, which it looks like I'm going to do. I mean, I'm just going to take that, because there's nothing else in the pack. But those are quite interesting packs, that they all have very good gold cards. This card's not that good, by the way. The other cards were all very good. Okay, here I think the options are Time to Feed and Seep of the Hammock. I'm inclined to take Time to Feed here. I think if I end up blue-black, I'll probably have more opportunities to grab removal spells. But if I end up green, I won't. And I already have Griptide in Voyage's End, so I mean, those are true removal spells, but I don't need removal spells that badly. This pack is super good. Wow. This is the first time I see this pack, right? Yeah. So there are a lot of playables here. I think the options are Lash of the Whip and Vapor Can. Lash of the Whip is better, but Vapor Can is just only blue, and I don't have a single black card yet. So I'm just going to take Vapor Can. I think it goes well with the bounce spells that I have. Okay, I'm going to take the Monster here. It's not that great a card, but if you're playing against another blue deck, it's very good. And I don't know, it seems better than the one for that adds mana. That card is very good in some decks, not that good in others. So taking the Monopole here. I have some good targets already. I have Riptide, a Voyage's End, and a Lightning Strike, so. And Anchor's Form or Gensei. Gensei is a decent cyber card, it's not great. Anchor's Form is also a decent cyber card, I guess. Yeah, I'll take Daggers Form here. There's a chance I want, like, heroic green dudes or something. Yeah, the spec does not matter. Okay, those two cards are actually playable. I can't imagine what other people took from that pack. They had, like, the Lash of the Whip and stuff. All everyone had taken a card out of that deck already, and some of those cards were actually very good. So it's probably not good for me that I got a card that good that late. Okay, I guess I'll just stay the name is Knight here. The other option is Dividing Satyr, which could be better than Nemesis Knight in some decks, but since I don't actually know that I'll be green yet, at this point I'm just mono blue. And it looks like I'll. There's a Lightning Strike or a Vapor Cannon. Okay, so I like Vapor Cannon a lot, especially if I have two Naiads. But Lightning Strike is so good that I think I should take it. I already have one. If I had zero, I wouldn't take it. But I can just play blue-red. And if I play blue-green, I can always splash it. I might even wield this temple. So I think this is the right pick. I might end up not playing it, but I think it's better. Okay, there's an Angered Gods, which is potentially good. Let's see what we have. Let's hide Avers form. Angered Gods is quite an interesting card, because it's not good with Vapor King, obviously, but I don't necessarily have to be aggressive with the cards that I have. I don't have many creatures yet. Or I could just take the Chimera. I think Angered God has the gods has a higher payout, even if it's just a cyborg card. Ooh, now there's a Dryad. Dryad is very good. This is by far the best card in the pack. It would. So my choices are the Dryad or the Minotaur, which is good. It's not bad. It's definitely good with the flyers. I think I should probably take the Dryad here and keep my options a little bit open. I know it's kind of late to be keeping your options open. As in, this is the end of pack 2. But, I mean, I'm going to be heavy blue, and I can always splash Lightning Strikes if I have to. Okay, this pack is also very good. There are a bunch of very good cards. I'm just going to take the Disciple here, I think. Useless Melee. Unfortunately, cannot take that. I don't really want Carnate of Assault in this deck. I'll probably just take Traveler's Amulet so I can splash the Lightning Strikes. And do I take the Nylea's Presence here to splash the Lightning Strikes again? Or do I take the Spear Point Orid? I don't know. This is kind of like basically the draft decision. Like, this is the fork I have to go on those two colors now. But if I go green, then I still keep the good red cards. Whereas if I go red, I ignore the green cards. I think going green is better. For just the same reason that I just said. Like, okay, we're good for mana fixing, I think. I did not will the land. Huh. Okay. We should have taken the Chain to the Rocks. My deck is a lot different now than I expected it was going to be when I was drafting. Because I have some very good cards and some cards that don't do anything. So I think with the start that I had, my deck could have turned out a lot better. But it's not turning out bad. Yeah, I guess I'll take the draw spell, probably not played. Okay, now I'm taking this. I'm not going to play the Threaten, and this card is very good. So I don't want someone having like three of them. Any potential cyborg card? I mean, I could theoretically still abandon green and go, because the green cards I have are all mana fixing. And Time to Fit is not that good in my deck. I don't have many guys that fight. So how many cards I have if I don't play green? I have 14, so I need 9. That's not impossible.